Before creating your ePortfolio, you will need to log in to VIA. You can log into VIA using the More button in one of your course pages in D2L. Simply click on More on the right-hand side and choose VIA Homepage. You can also log in directly by clicking on vialivetext.com. In order to create your ePortfolio, choose ePortfolios from the left-hand column, then choose Create ePortfolio from the right-hand side. We're going to create from blank page. Give your ePortfolio a name and description. You can edit your name and your description later. Then click Create. You're now ready to begin your ePortfolio. Once inside the VIA ePortfolio Creator, you can see that there are 7 main tabs across the top of the page. Add Content is where you can add components and pages to your ePortfolio. You can choose a theme for your ePortfolio. You can edit your description and add a cover image. You can share your ePortfolio after it's made public by copying the URL or sharing to social media or through email. You can also view your work in progress. There's not a lot to see at the moment. You can save and you can close. Once you save your ePortfolio, you will see that it appears in your listing of ePortfolios from your main ePortfolio page. In order to go back into the ePortfolio to edit it, simply click on that ePortfolio. You will add components and pages to your VIA ePortfolio from the Add Content button in the upper left-hand corner of VIA. You can add text, images, an image gallery, video files, or file uploads to your ePortfolio from the Components tab, and you can add, rename, and reorder pages from the Pages tab. This page is called the Introduction. If I want to change its name, I can choose More Options, Edit, and change the name of the page. If I wanted to, I could also change the location of the page. It now appears after About Me. Let's work on the About Me page by making it active and choosing to add components. Let's add a text box to this active cell. I can tell it's the active cell because it has a dark blue line around the cell. In order to add new rows and columns, I can click on the button in the lower left-hand corner of the active cell, and I can add a row with a designated number of columns and click Add. In order to delete one of my cells, I simply choose the trash can option from the upper right-hand corner of the active cell. Let's add a text box to the About Me top cell. I will click on Text Box, and I'm going to choose to skip the label for this first text box. It is optional. I will click Save. I can click to edit the text inside the text box. I can use the built-in text editor to change the look of my text. I can also insert multimedia, insert links, or add content from my timeline in VIA. Choosing the next active cell will save the text I've put inside the text box. In this next cell, let's add an image by clicking on the Image tab. I will label this image, Image 1. In order to insert an image, I click the Insert Image button that appears within the active cell. I can upload an image from my computer, from my timeline, from Google Drive, or from Dropbox. Once I upload my file, I give it a short name. And click Save. The image now appears in the active cell. If I want to add a caption for the image, I simply add a text box within the same cell. And I can caption my image. I can move to the next active cell to save my text box. In the next active cell, let's add an image gallery. I click Insert Image Gallery, and then I can browse for images, or again, upload them from my timeline, from Google Drive, or from Dropbox. Once you upload the first image and add a short description, you can upload the image and browse for a new image. Once you've uploaded all of the images you want to appear in your image gallery, click Save. Your reader can now view both images simply by clicking on the short version of the image in the image gallery. Let's add another row. In the next active cell, we want to add a video. Let's add a label for the video. And click Insert Video. In order to insert a video, you can paste a YouTube URL or you can upload a video from your timeline. Once you add your video, click Save. If you decide you don't want a video in your cell, you can choose the Delete button for the video or for any of the types of components. In order to add a file upload, simply click on File Upload and choose the file you want to upload from your computer, from your timeline, from Google Drive, or from Dropbox. And click Save. Once live, your reader will be able to download your file. Once you've added all of the components you want to appear on a particular page, you can choose Pages and move to the next page. Click Save to save your work and return to the main menu of ePortfolios.